Hi, welcome to the episode 7 of Azure Data Factory tutorial full course. In this session, we will see how you can create your first pipeline where we will copy the data from our Azure SQL database to Azure Blob storage. So I'm Deepak Goyal, having 12 years of experience in IT, and I am a certified Azure solution architect. So let's begin our video. And don't forget to subscribe the channel if you haven't subscribed the channel yet, meanwhile. So let's dive to the Azure portal. I already have an Azure Data Factory account. So on portal.azure.com, I'll go to this Azure Data Factory account. And let's go to the Author Monitor tab. For creating the pipeline, we need to use the link service and DataSet. I am using it, which we have created in our previous episodes. So you can go back to those sessions and see how you can create the link service and the DataSet. Just doing a quick recap, you need to have a one link service which connect to our Azure SQL database. We need to have a one link service which connect to our Azure storage account. And similarly, for Azure SQL database, we need to have one data set which will pull the data, and we need to have another data set for Azure Blob storage which will save the data into the CSV format. So we need to know, we need to have two link service and two data set. Good, for creating your pipeline, go to the Author tab. So I repeat one more time, I have already used the created link services and dataset which we have made in the previous episodes. Now let's see how we can create the pipeline. Just click on plus sign and say click pipeline. Your first pipeline is here. In the properties section, you can give the name of the pipeline. So let's say copy from SQL to storage. You can give the descriptions and you can give concurrency. I'll tell you what is the concurrency later on. Now, pipeline is nothing without the activity. You need to add the activity. The most common activity we have is the copy activity. We just simply move the data from your blobs, your SQL database to a blob storage. So in the activities search box, search copy, you get this copy data activity. Copy activity has two things. One is source and another one is sync. Source is the source from where you want to pull the data. In our case, we want to pull the data from the Azure SQL database, which we already have a data set in the name SQL DS. So I'll select it as a source. Now, when you want to pull the data, you can give the query, or you can, so that it, let's say for example, you want to pull the data in some specific format. Let's say you want to pull the only the two columns of the table, or you want to pull the entire table or few rows of the table. So based on that, you can give the query and it will select the data accordingly. As of now, I am giving the complete table, so it will pull the entire data. There are other options. You can set the query timeout. You can set the parameters. You can set few additional columns as well if you want to move it. So for now, I want to keep it very simple. And let's just see how this copy activity runs. And then in the later on advanced videos, we will see all these advanced options. So go to the sync. In the source, we have already selected the Azure SQL dataset. In the sync, we want to store it into the CSV format in blob storage. So select the dataset and rest keep as its default. Now your copy data is here. Activity is ready to run. You can change the name here, like say copy from SQL to storage. Still, you can see that there is a copy data written on the top of the activity so that it will be easy to identify that this is a copy activity. Now, to just test it, you can click on debug. The moment you click on debug, the actual data transfer will happen from the SQL database to this storage. So let's just check it. I just click on debug. Here in the bottom, you have this output screen. It will automatically refresh in every 5 seconds. Here you can see that our activity has been executed successfully and our whole pipeline has only one activity. That's why our pipeline execution has been successful. You can click on this preview icon and you can see that the copy from the SQL database to blob storage has been done successfully. The number of rows it has written is 295. And it also says the size of the data it has been read and it has been write. Now let's just go to our blob storage and just check if we got the file or not. So I'm just going to it. And here you can see that we have our order.csv ready. That's all from this session. Here we have learned our first pipeline creation in Azure Data Factory. I hope you have liked this video. And if you really like it, please press the like icon. And if you haven't subscribed the channel, please do subscribe the channel as well. If you have any comments, any queries, or any suggestion, please put them in the drop box and I will try to answer as early as possible. Till then, goodbye, keep learning.